what?
Stop the pitching.
Well, look what the rat dragged in.
Can it? I know something Ragsling will want to hear.
Yeah? What's that?
I've been in some druid's grove. This one's spring me. Now move over so I can tell Ragsling myself.
Hold on. Where are the raiders?
Dead. Every last one.
Hear that?
She'll be happy enough when I tell her where them lubies is holing up. Through.
Hold on now. Is it true what Saz says? You helped her escape that grove. A quiet type, eh? Good. Keep out of trouble, or you and Saz will get it.
That's enough out of you. Come on, gotta let the drow know where them looters is. We'll be heroes.
Next time, Grim will be on guard duty. Right, boss?
Something good here, I hope.
Is irresistible. You recognize the overwhelming authority that you've used on others, only infinitely stronger, and turned against you. Your vision clouds, leaving you in a dark, featureless shadowscape. Nothingness in every direction. Then there are three figures before you. An armored male elf, exuding power and command. A handsome younger man with a quick, easy smile, and a pale young woman with even paler eyes.
These are my chosen. They speak for me. Aid their search for the prison, and you will be worthy to stand beside them.
Give me that look. I don't know what just happened any more than you do. We should keep going.
The voice is gone. Muted by this Gith relic. Why does a half-elf carry it?
that was the Absolute speaking to us. But we managed to shield ourselves. We should keep moving. I don't know. Not exactly. All I know is it's important I get it back to Baldur's Gate. At any cost. I suppose, if we're to continue together, I may as well tell you. I serve Shah. My home is a secret cloister in Baldur's Gate. A group of us was sent to retrieve the artifact. Now I'm the only one left. I can't afford to fail. I can't tell you anymore. This mission required utmost secrecy. We all submitted to having our memories suppressed so that we couldn't betray Shah's confidence. If I reach my contact in the city, I'll have my memories restored. Until then, I have to guard the artifact with my life. There. You have the truth, for all it's worth. Let's continue.
I knew it.
No need to thank me. This is out of pure necessity. Pure desperation, in fact. There's nothing more I can tell you. All I remember is that I have to get back to my contact in the city.
I know those symbols. Githyanki runes. Ancient as Vlakith herself. You stole that from my people.
Yes. And a lot of my people died in the process. I won't fail them. Not after what I saw your kind do to them.
A powerful artifact indeed, to have caught the attention of so many. Not least the Absolute itself. The three figures in the vision, the Chosen, are searching for it. With the cultists' aid, it will not be long before they find it. Before they find you. Evaded them so far, thanks, it seems, to the artifact itself. But how long can such protection last? Shadowheart has made her position clear. She will see that it is taken to its destination. At any cost. No doubt the Githyanki will seek to reclaim that which is theirs. And you still do not know what it even is.
I trust you more than most. But I'm sorry. That's too much to ask. This is my responsibility. If you insist, but make it quick. We have far bigger concerns. True. I didn't think you'd react so pragmatically. Perhaps I should have told you sooner. Gladly.
Goes nothing.
What about the priest?
That's curious.
Sounds like they've captured themselves at the bar.
Or be you beheaded!
A stranger in a fair camp.
With fragulous crown and with scepter abraid, draw Ragslin, short work of the innkeeper, made. The inn burnt to ash. The captives were many. Goblin kind had reduced them to cowering filfenny. So raise it, your goblets, and drain them with pride. Draw Raxlin, the true soul, had led you galant.
You! Move off!
Do as she says. Now. Now, where was I?
Wait a tick. That a friend of yours?
Oh, certainly not. What are you doing? I'm busy here.
You lying.
To you? Never. Come, let's continue our ballad. draw Raxlin, draw Raxlin. I am.
You broke him!
Wait, wait. Draw Raxlin, we pay.
Come on, pigeon. Back to your cage.
Now, look what you've done.
Come on!
Of course, ma'am.
My name's Gribbo, idiot!
Right, yes. More fool me.
You going on the next raid? Bring me back something.
This
pretty.
Is making my head hurt.
Get off your own. Do your own thing.
You look like you got something jingling in your pocket. Looking to spend it? get moving. I got stuff, if you got coin. Get moving.
that blood? Never mind. Can't slow down.
May the darkness protect you.
Quite the understatement, but yes, I have it. And I'll guard it with my life. And so be it. I did my duty. As for the artifact, it's powerful and has a mind. Don't forget what it was like when you heard the voice. It'll only get worse if you don't have the artifact to protect you. I was part of a group sent by my cloister. We were to take the artifact from the Githyanki and bring it to Baldur's. Though it turned out the cost was very steep. I was the only one of the group to survive. That's all I know. That's all I need to know. That's not a luxury open to many people, us included. I have my faith to turn to instead. Shah's secrets must be protected. Duty demands it. Once I fulfill the wound on my hand, it never quite heals. And sometimes it causes terrible pain to rip through me. It's my burden, though, from Lady Shah. I can feel her influence somehow. I cannot say. Not with what I can recall. But even then, it would not be for me to question her will. Lady Shah has her reasons. I'm sure you do. But please try to understand that it's not something I can just talk about freely.
There's potential in you. Let's see how you handle this. I am indeed a disciple of Shah. Mistress, I assume you've heard of her. My Lady Shah is the Night Singer, the patron of most fear the dark. Like Chilth, but Shah teaches pain. We shed those cloaks. Before Shah, we stand gloriously naked, beyond the vanities of mortals. We tear down the there's often suffering, death even. Many people break before they embrace Shah's truths. Curious. Most are afraid. I think I did well by joining you. Most agreeable company. You already know my biggest secrets. What more can you ask? What, besides my life's core? Well, I like night orchids and can't swim. Is that the sort of thing you meant? It's a deal. No, quite literally. If I manage to return to Baldur's Gate and fulfill, of course. It is an act of faith, not to be undertaken lightly. Shah will reward me when I succeed. Fine. What's on your mind? I don't think I've ever had a confidant quite like you. And if I have, I...
Yes?
speak. Soldier.
Well met.
Go ahead. I'm listening.
Ah, yes. Karsus was perhaps the most powerful wizard that ever lived. The child who would be a god. And he tried. With a spell of his own devising, he endeavored to usurp in one fell swoop. Mistril, she was called then. Imagine what it must have felt like. To be a god. To know yourself, to be untouchable. As Karsus aimed his spell at her, she began to unravel. And with her, the entire weave. Too late did he realize what he had unleashed. It would have been the end of everything had not Mistril sacrificed. The goddess of magic is all magic. By dying, the entire weave was lost, and the spell that challenged a god failed. It was the end of Mistril. The end of Karsus. As the child who would be a god was turned to stone, his empire came crashing down around him. The floating cities of Netheril, an event that came to be known as Karsus's folly. For a spell, Mistril was reborn as Mistra. Upon her return, the weave returned with her. Now, so many centuries later, I try to follow in the footsteps of Karsus. Not to destroy Mistra, but to prove my love for her. I tried to control only a fraction of the magic that was unleashed that fateful day. I merely sought to return one tiny diamond to an imperfect crown. Gale's folly, one might call it. History. Repetition. It's the way things go. I assure you it's not.
Don't get me wrong. You did well. The somatic component, the verbal component, even the focus on the inner self that invites Mistra in.
But I was still your conduit. To perform such a feat alone requires much and arduous study. Of course, as a paladin, your patron deity endows you with many such powers otherwise unattainable. I do hope you cherish that gift. If it should ever come to that, if I ever know I am no longer able to stop it, I will do anything I can to ensure no one but me pays for my mistakes. I will find the remotest place on the surface of Faerun, or perhaps far below in the depths of the Underdark. I will await that death. Alone. I promise I will not betray your trust. You kept me by your side despite the menace that I am. If worst comes to worst, I will be long gone before the curtain falls.
Dedicated to her, and now it's a nest for some filthy goblins. A fitting end.
You to the draft. Yeah, keep the absolute happy.
any turns. Must have read my mind, you know. Magic again. Who's
there? More for me?
Trevor, be cautious.
This other guy twirls his whip. And the dwarf just bleeding, just stands back up.
Looks like the booze got the better of them. They're practically unconscious.
You crash about like a drunken ogre. Oh, rip your tongue. Break your legs. Make you quiet.
As the symbol glows, power courses through you. Authority.
What did you bring for me? Nothing! I'll break your skull! More prey!
Soldier.
Might be useful.
Loose brickwork. Best not lean against it.
What's in here?
Then he turns. Can't break my mind, you know. And he raises his arms. Magic again. So I grab his hand. Crush him.
Moisture drips down your forehead. Pain shoots through your fingers. Your hands shake as they reach upward. Your forehead remains drenched no matter how much you wipe.
Chukilgake vlaketh mazathok! Can you feel it crawling through you? Tendrils squirming in your chest, gripping your heart, piercing your belly, your bones popping, your flesh swelling. I can. I see it in you. I feel it in me. We are lost. I will be quick with my blade. First you, then the others, then myself.
Your minds intertwine. You sense a touch of uncertainty, a touch of disgust.
I cannot trust my own mind, so it seems I must trust yours. I will wait, but know this, I am watching. If the sickness does not pass come dawn, I will end us all.
I came just in time. You are transforming.
Combative. Good. You'll need to be.
Don't worry. You will not become a mind flayer. Not while I'm around. I'll protect you. Independent. Good. We haven't much time, so listen closely. There is great potential within you. It comes from that parasite. Your instinct is to resist the power it gives, but you must accept it. Nurture it. I will keep it from consuming you, but for the sake of both of us, you must learn to wield it. A fight for the fate of Faerun. A fight we are losing.
for now. You can change that, but only if you embrace your potential. I have to go. The enemy is closing in. I will be back.
Dog pants through a ball held firmly in his mouth. He relinquishes the ball. It is well chewed and slick with drool.
Still breathing.